Now I am going to introduce some examples to illustrate the intermediate value theorem. In the first example, we are going to show that the equation cosine of x equals x squared has at least one solution in R. First of all, we are going to rewrite this equation as cosine of x minus x squared equals zero. So to show that this equation has a solution in R, we have to prove that there exists some C in R such that cosine of C minus C squared is equal to zero. So we are going to apply the intermediate value theorem by considering the function given by f of x equals cosine of x minus x squared. And note that this function is continuous on the whole real line. And we are going to test this function on a few inputs. And if we can show that there exists some a such that f of a is less than zero, and there exists some b such that f of b is greater than zero, then because this function is continuous on R, we can apply the intermediate value theorem on the interval ab and conclude that the equation f of x equals zero has a solution in the open interval ab. And over here, we can see that f of zero is cosine of zero minus zero square, and cosine of zero here is equal to one. This is the cosine axis, and this is the trigonometric circle. Cosine of zero is one. Cosine of pi over two is zero. Cosine of pi is minus one. Cosine of three pi over two is zero. Cosine of two pi is one, and so on. Okay, that's a quick review for the trigonometric circle. So over here again, f of zero is cosine of zero minus zero square, and this is greater than zero. Okay, f of pi over 2 is equal to cosine of pi over 2 minus pi over 2 squared. And if you look at the trigonometric circle here and the cosine axis, you can see that cosine of pi over 2 is equal to 0. So f of pi over 2 is equal to cosine of pi over 2 minus pi over 2 squared. And this is minus pi squared over 4, which is less than zero. Okay, so we have that f of zero times f of pi over two is less than zero. So by the first version of the intermediate value theorem, there is some c in the interval AB over here. This is the interval zero, pi over two, such that f of c equals zero, or again cosine of c equals c squared. Therefore, this equation has a solution in R. In the second example, we are going to show that the equation x to the fourth minus 2x to the third minus x minus 1 equals 0 has at least two solutions in R. In general, for a continuous function defined on R, if we can find three numbers, a1, a2, and a3, such that f of a1 is greater than 0, f of a2 is less than 0, and f of a3 is greater than 0, then first of all, we can apply the intermediate value theorem on the interval a1, a2 to see that there exists a solution c1 in the open interval a1, a2. And similarly, we can apply the intermediate value theorem on the second interval a2, a3 to see that this equation f of x equals 0 has another solution in the open interval a2, a3. And as a conclusion, the equation f of x equals 0 has at least two solutions in R. Let's go ahead and apply that general idea to this particular problem. So we consider the function given by f of x equals x to the fourth minus 2x to the third minus x minus 1 defined on the whole real line. Note that f is continuous on R, and we have that f of 0 is minus 1, which is less than 0. F of 3 is 10 to 3, which is greater than 0. And f of minus 3 is 137, which is greater than 0 as well. So first of all, we are going to apply the intermediate value theorem on the interval from minus 3 to 0, and see that because f of minus 3 is greater than 0 and f of 0 is less than 0. So the given equation has a solution in the open interval from minus 3 to 0. And similarly, because f of 0 is less than 0 and f of 3 is greater than 0. So we can apply again the intimate value theorem on the interval 0 to 3 and see that this equation has another solution in the open interval 0, 3. As a conclusion, the given equation has at least two solutions in R. Again, the intermediate value theorem plays a very important role in this example.